replace the motors, because they drag racing. So,
yeah, they drag race. We do mostly chassis work, and we put motor plates, mid plates, and everything in it. And it depends on what they want. But we can do anything.
You can do the motor.
We don't build motors, no.
No, but you can buy a crate.
Yeah, I can buy a motor or have a motor built for them or something.
And you'll put it in then.
Yeah, we'll install it. We install transmissions. That transmission right there is a Power Glide 2-speed, all aftermarket, but it also has an overdrive on it. And that's going in that silver Mustang over there.
And that's a drag race.
Yeah, the drag race. So is the overdrive. It's all made for...
What's silver Mustang?
What's that?
Where's the silver Mustang?
It's over here. We'll go over there. Yeah.
Premec transmissions?
They're
nowhere near strong enough.
Okay.
They're only rated for about 600 horsepower.
Oh, okay.
The motor in that Mustang will give me 1240.
So it surely has slicks. It doesn't have slicks.
No, it's got drag radials on it.
They have a
same
tire.
So he'll drive it on the street.
He's going to a race called Drag Week, where there's five tracks. Like every day, you have to drive it to that track. The average mileage is 200 to 250 miles. You have to drive it. Then you race it, then you sleep, and then you get up and you drive to the next track.
Oh, darn. Yeah, the rules are interesting.
And they got different rules. They got, the non-tub, more street-driven style cars, and they got the Outlaws, which is like a pro mod car, any kind of car you want to race, as long as it can make the cruise.
Are most of them automatics now?
Yeah, 99% of them are. Unfortunately.
I was going to say, I'm a clutch guy.
What type of welding masks do you have?
Those are automatics. They're for TIG welding. For as soon as you strike an arc, they darken, and you got different darkness. You got, black and all the way to light, depending on your eyesight and everything.
Because I saw them, that's what they kind of look like in paintball.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot more expensive than paintball.
Might be a little big for you, but you get the idea. There you go.
Let's see ya.
There you go.
It's not very dark right now, right?
He can see, though.
No, I can't.
You can't see that?
This little wire piece is, that's where my eyes are. It's just like,
See, look through it like this, you can see. Look through it like that. See? You can see.
Yeah, because it's not darkened yet.
Yeah,
my first pair of glasses, right? I was going to the other guy. That's interesting. And his welding masks are like the ordinary. And also, what is this?
That's a sheet metal brake for bending sheet metal.
So that's what they need to rescue from using to bend his metal.
Mm-hmm.
They stick a piece of metal in it and then it just bends it.
Yep. Bends it a nice straight line.
Bends it just like, here's a pretty good.
You can bend it at any angle, 45, 10, 90, whatever you want.
But there's several transmissions that you use in
drag. You have to be careful around here.
Or any of them are straight, or just drag.
There's a Lenco 4C. That's all.
What's this for?
That's a bead roller. That's for putting these patterns in metal right here. That's what we use that machine for, to make patterns in metal.
Is this TIG welded, Terry?
Yes, everything's TIG welded. We don't really do any wire welding except when we have to weld a plate to the sheet metal, and we can't TIG weld it because it's so impregnated with galvanized that it just spits. And so we wire weld the plate, and then we TIG weld from there. Okay. Sometimes we have to cut a hole in the floor. We'll grind it back. Put a patch panel in there. We use silicon bronze and TIG weld it like that. But for strength, we have to wire weld it. Your silicon bronze is what we welded that sheet metal in with. It's kind of a different color.
Yeah.
It's a bronze look. Yeah, that's on brass.
So what's this going to be?
65 Chevy pickup.
Why the height?
As far as Them trucks are tall. That's what I see. Look how high you mess it off the floor to see it over the dash. It's a one time build right here.
It's still pretty close to the ground.
Oh yeah, it'll sit off the ground up that high once it's done.
Yeah. Well, I noticed where you add all the metal.
Yeah.
I don't understand all the purposes.
We had to raise the bed up, which is kind of cool because back in the quality control and afterthought wasn't quite there in the 60s.
I have a question.
But hold we on. Raised the bed up and it matches the body line, but we needed to raise it up to get the great big tire. We're putting 35-inch tall tires underneath it that are about that tall, but it's only going to sit about that high off the ground. So we raised the bed up, but to get the running board back with the bottom of the rocker, we extended it down. So once we paint it and get everything done, we never know what we're doing.
Will you put the motor in this one?
Yes. This will be another turnkey car.
And what motor will that be?
It's got a 903 cubic inch motor for it.
In areas that I don't even understand.
Yeah, it's over the top. I mean, it made 1,510 or 40 horsepower on pump gas.
So this is the wire that you've been using?
Four systems of nitrous will make almost 3,000 horsepower.
Is this the wire that you've been using to
weld
it?
Yeah, that's filler rod, yes.
So is it okay if I touch it?
Stuff here?
Yeah, you can touch it.
Do what?
You got some Mentor Brothers stuff here.
Yeah.
Don't bend it, though.
We took it to a railway shop.
Ray was just here. They're one of their engineers. He came up for a friend of his wedding. He was here this morning.
For
Ray does all the designing and everything. I've known him since the mid-90s.
On a book.
I know Mike Mentor since the mid-early 80s. He used to build our sockets. And yeah. I started out building our sockets to change tires with. Mm-hmm. Now it's
okay. Now that I'm over, but when you get over 50, you have to have an EKG. So they put me on they give you the EKG and stuff, and put you under a little bit of, they don't give you a stress test, but they make, he told me last time, I'm 60 now, he said my heart rate recovers faster than any 35-year-old has ever seen.
You know, Terry, I'll be 71 in about a week, and I just went on cholesterol medication. Blood medication, I don't take it. That's actually about 6 months ago.
Well, I've started a couple of them. Blood pressure.
Yeah, it's a lot of things now.
There's all kinds of doses.
Looks like it's.
This is probably because it's coming by her or they dipped it.
Is it on both sides?
No. It looks like they just put a little bit of carbon fiber around it. But this looks like carbon fiber.
Look at these big. Like this big board thing there.
I thought that I think they put the cars on.
Looks like it.
And then look at them. Look. My uncle will start off with those.
Yeah, lots it's of different masks.
You have to watch out for everything. It's just like.
Yep, you have to be careful.
Look at it's a grill. Like.
Yeah.
I think he's got his money worth.
It was a losing battle. Then you had guys. You had a guy out of Michigan. World's largest glass recycling. That's for a couple gals that wanted some artwork done. I do a lot of artwork too. I make stuff out of metal.
I want a feather.
yeah, they're not
save
cheap.
Save your money for a couple years.
Oh, it's not that bad. I got some pictures of.
A stab person. What is this? Good
for you. That cuts metal. That's a stomp shear.
There's a little bit of carbon fiber.
Yep.
Would that be internet sales though?
Right now, I hope not.
I don't blame you.
But it's just going to be local stuff because we did a market
research.
So this
research. Is what it's made out of?
Yeah. You can have that if you want.
Ooh.
Yeah. Carbon fiber.
It's going to be local because we did a market research. There, well, I know for a fact.
Carbon fiber is one of the strongest materials on earth.
Speed shop in this town since Ronnie's back in the late 70s.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to have one. And the market area in this, in I don't think a lot of people know it, but the Kansas City metropolitan area, not including Kansas, is the third largest metropolitan in the U.S. Yeah.
Because I was saying Kansas City was around
2.4.
But you got Raytown.
Like rubbery.
Well, this looks like a conveyor belt, but I don't know what it does.
Right.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Who knew? Yes. Never know.
Not one speed check.
Wow. Yeah.
So I figured if I could just tap into 10%.
Do you have a dog?
Yeah. I got two basset
hounds. Where?
They're at home. It's their day off.
But, of course. I've never heard of them. The dogs
I own everything, so and there hasn't been one, and everybody's always screaming, "We need a speed shop. I need to buy this. I need to buy that." Most guys come up and buy fitties and tent, but I don't have what they need. So, but I will over here.
Stock it.
Yeah.
You have enough room.
Well, that's what this place is for. This part over here is going to be for jobs and stuff for that side. This side over here will be all inventory for the speed shop. And upstairs, I can put it all up there too, because it's all done. Everything's built on 16-inch centers with 3/4-inch plywood.
Oh,
speed
hold.
Shop coming.
Right now, my wife's going to. So I'm going to sell and kind of bounce back and forth.
How many employees do you have then that work on cars?
Three of us.
Yeah, good.
It's hard. It's impossible.
To get.
First of all, because you've got to know. The kid who worked for me, he came here when he was 19, didn't know anything. I taught him how to do everything. He's 30 now, and he's as good, maybe a little better than me. And the other guy's an old retired guy. I've raced with him since the 70s, and he comes in to do just, he just loves to make stuff and piddle. And Bill Woody, Doug Woody's brother. His brother owns a machine shop, does motors. So. And I've tried, you know, what's so funny.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Not a problem. Anytime.
It gets in your blood and it's hard to get out.
You can't get it out. Well, thanks for coming.
Well, bye, guys.
Again, Terry, thanks for doing